Hello students, welcome to the class. Today we will discuss about the solution topic. From this topic you will get surely one question in all MCQ, all multiple choice exams. In CET also you will get the question. So here we are discussing the main points on. You know how to calculate the molarity, molality, mole fraction and normal. Go through the formulas, go through all the formulas. Once again repeat all the formulas. After that we have to discuss about the solubility. So first read out concentration and methods expressing the concentration terms. In those methods, the main ones are molarity, molality, normality, mole fraction. First, complete those four topics. Okay. After that, our next topic is solubility. So what is meant by solubility? Solubility means amount of substance dissolved in a specified amount of solvent. Amount of substance dissolved in a specified amount of solvent. Basing on the amount of substance present in the solution. Solutions are of three types: saturated solutions, unsaturated solutions and supersaturated solutions. Saturated substances are those which contains exactly the same amount of the substance which it can be dissolved in the substance, which it can be dissolved in the liquid. So the amount of the specified amount of liquid dissolved in the liquid is exactly the same thing. So those kind of solutions are known as the saturated solutions. Unsaturated solutions are those in which further more amount of solute can be dissolved. Supersaturated solutions are those in which more amount of substances are dissolved in the solution, which contains more amount of solute. Generally, these supersaturated solutions forms the precipitates. Supersaturated solutions forms the precipitate. Unsaturated solutions further dissolve some more amount of substance. Saturated solutions are those in which the exact amount of substance, how much it can be dissolved, is already dissolved in that substance. So these are the three kind of solutions: saturated, supersaturated and unsaturated solutions. Next we have to discuss about the solubility of solids. This solubility of solids depends on temperature, nature of solute or solvent, and third one is pressure. On these three factors, solubility of solids depends. First one is temperature effect. How the solubility depends on temperature. If solubility is exothermic process, solubility decreases. Okay, so some of the substance dissolution releases energies. So in those substances, as temperature increases, solubility decreases. Next point, if solubility is exothermic process, if solubility is exothermic process, as temperature decreases, solubility increases. As temperature decreases, solubility increases. So this is the effect of temperature. First, you have to look at whether the dissolution of that particular substance is exothermic or endothermic. If it is an exothermic process, then at low temperature solubility is more, at high temperature solubility is less. If the dissolution is endothermic process, okay, we made it reverse. If the solubility is exothermic, then as temperature decreases, solubility increases. Suppose if you made this one as endothermic, then as temperature increases, solubility is also increases. If it is exothermic process, as temperature increases, solubility decreases. As temperature decreases, solubility increases. If it is an exothermic, I just repeated the same thing. Now we will take another condition. If it is an endothermic process, then as temperature increases, solubility also increases. So this is about the effect of temperature on the solubility. Next, look at the nature of solute and solvent. Nature of solute and solvent. The second condition. Polar substances dissolves in polar solvents. Polar substances dissolves in polar solvents. Polar substances dissolves in polar solvents. Polar substances are dissolved in polar solvents. Non-polar substances dissolve in non-polar solvents. This is the general condition. Polar substances are more soluble in polar solvents. Non-polar substances are more soluble in non-polar solvents. But this condition is not applicable to in all the cases. It is the general condition only. Next, another condition is substances which undergo ionization or reaction with the solvent. Substances which undergoes reaction or ionization in the solvents are more soluble. So if the substance is undergoing ionization, it is more soluble. It is somewhat more soluble. Next one is pressure effect. The effect of pressure on the solubility of solids in liquids, is negligible. Okay? So pressure effect is negligible on the solubility of solids in liquids. Next, we have to look at the solubility of gas in liquid. Solubility of gas in liquids. So what is the solubility of gas in liquids? The solubility of gas in liquids depends on again different factors. One of the factors is nature of gas. Nature of gas. Second one is nature of solvent. Nature of gas. Nature of solvent. The third factor is temperature. And the fourth factor is pressure. So solubility of gas in liquids depends on these factors. The first one is nature of gas. First factor is nature of gas. So how the solubility of gas, the solubility of gas depends on the, how the solubility of gas is going to depend on critical temperature. Gases which have more critical temperature are liquefied easily. Are liquefied easily. And they are more soluble. And they are more soluble. Gas which have more critical temperatures are liquefied easily and they are more soluble. Next, it means if the gas is liquefying easily, then that gas is more soluble in liquids. Next one is nature of solvent. Next one is the nature of solvent. Gases which undergoes ionization, easily in water are more soluble. So if the gas is not undergoing ionization, that gas is less soluble. If the gas undergoes ionization, that gas is more soluble. So ions forming gases are more soluble. Next, temperature effects. How this temperature will influence the solubility of gas? At low temperature, not too much low, at low temperature, solubility of gas in liquids are low. At low temperature, solubility of gas in liquids at low temperature, solubility of gas in liquid is more. As temperature increases, the dissolved gases comes out. As temperature increases, the dissolved gases comes out. For that only cool drinks, generally these soft drinks are placed in fridge. In cold conditions, soft drinks are placed in cold conditions. Why? At low temperature, solubility of gas is more. As temperature, keep that cold drinks, if you keep that cold drinks, the cool drinks in hot conditions, what happens? The soluble gas tries to comes out from the liquid. So when it is comes out from the liquids, what happens? A pressure develops and the bottle will go into more. So the cooling bottles are placed in cold condition due to this reason, because low temperature solubility is more. Next, pressure effects. The effect of pressure on the solubility of gas in liquids. The effect of pressure on the solubility of gas in liquids are explained by Henry's law. The solubility of gas in liquids explained by Henry's law. So what is Henry's law? The partial pressure of gas dissolved in the liquid is directly proportional to mole fraction of the gas. Partial pressure of gas dissolved in the liquid is directly proportional to mole fraction of the gas dissolved. So partial pressure is equal to KH into X. So partial pressure of gas is equal to Henry's law constant of the gas into mole fraction of the gas. Again, to calculate the mole fraction, we have some formula. Mole fraction of solute equal to molality by molality plus 55.5. You remember this formula. So while doing the problems, we are going to use this one. Next, another one is mole fraction is equal to number of moles. So I am taking this mole fraction of second one is equal to number of moles of second one by total number of moles. Number of moles of second one by total number of moles. So mole fraction of solute is equal to molality by molality plus 55.5. Mole fraction of second one is equal to number of moles of second one by total number of moles. So remember this formula. When we need those things, we have to use. Another one is partial pressure is equal to mole fraction into total pressure. You remember this formula. Now we will complete, we will solve the problems regarding this Henry's law. So in Henry's law we have a graph, they have shown the given a graph. In that graph they give the relationship between pressure and mole fraction. So as pressure increases, amount of substance also increases. Is shown with the structure. Next, come to Henry's law problems. Open page number 18. Page number 18. Question number 8. Four gases like H2, HE, CH4 and CO2 have Henry's law constant value of 69.16, 144.97, 0.413 and 1.67. The gas which is more soluble in liquid. So four gases are given. They given the KH values. And they are asking which gas is more soluble. Gases which are having less KH value less NB is Laban's land or more salary. H value less, more salary. So at a given pressure, if KH is reg, if KH is less, that gas is more soluble. So which gas has less KH value? CH4 has, Henry's law constant value. What is the CH4? H2, CH4. So which gas has H2 value is 69.16. H is 144.97. CH4 is 0.413. And another gas is, what is that gas? CO2. 1.67. So which gas has less KH value? CH4. So CH4 is more soluble. Next, seventh question, eighth question, ninth question. These three questions are regarding Henry's law. So look at the ninth question. Solubility of a gas in liquid increases. So solubility of a gas in liquids increases. So when the solubility will increase? At low temperatures. Means if you decrease the temperature, solubilities will increase. So that is about that one. Next one is equivalent weights. Next, open page number 20. What they are asking is M2O3 is converted into M2O5. M2O3 is converted into M2O5. They are asking the equivalent weight. What is the equivalent weight of M? Equivalent weight of M. What is the formula of our equivalent weight? Gram molecular weight by or gram atomic weight by number of electrons exchanged. So you have to count down the number of electrons exchanged. So look at what is the oxidation state of each M here plus 3. Here what is the oxidation state? Plus 5. In M2O3, if you take one mole of M2O3, how many M's are there? 2 M's means the total oxidation state of these 2 M's is plus 6. So here also in one mole 2 M's are there. So the total oxidation state is into 2. So how many electrons are exchanging when M2O3 is converted to M2O5? 4 electrons. So just substitute the gram molecular weight by 4. This is our answer. Look at question number 7 in question of page number 20. Here is 20. Question number 7. Equivalent weight of ammonia in base is, as a base is. So ammonia is a base, we know that one. Ammonia is a base. As a base, equivalent weight of ammonia is 70. How you get it at 70? According to Lewis acid base theory, according to Bradshaw acid base theory, the thing which donates H plus is a base. So they are saying, here NH3 convert to NH2 minus. In this process it donating 1H plus. So its acidity is 1. So equivalent weight is equal to equivalent weight of base. Equivalent weight of base is equal to gram molecular weight by acidity. Gram molecular weight by acidity. So gram molecular weight of ammonia is 17. Its acidity is 1, means 1 H plus is product. Next, our next problem is 8th one. Eighth problem. In an oxidation reduction reaction, MnO4 minus ion is converted to Mn2 plus. What is the number of equivalents of KMnO4 present in 250 ml of 0.04 m KMnO4 solution? So here a process is given, and that one is MnO4 minus is converting into Mn2 plus. So in this process, how many electrons are exchanging? 5 electrons. Because here the valence oxygen state is plus 7. Here the valence oxygen state is plus 2. So what is the difference number of electrons? 5 electrons. Means 5 electrons are exchanging during this process. They given the concentration of potassium permanganate. Okay, MnO4 minus when converted to Mn2 plus, how many electrons are exchanged? 5 electrons are exchanged. So here what they are asking is the oxidation number of what is the number of equivalents of KMnO4? Again, that given the concentration in molarity, so convert that one into normality. Normality is equal to molarity into N factor. Molarity is 0.04. N factor is how many electrons? 5 electrons. It becomes 5. So it is 0.2. Now you have to find out the equivalents. Normality is equal to number of gram equivalents. In 2000. By gram equivalent weight. So normality is equal to number of gram equivalents into 1000 by gram equivalent weight. Number of gram equivalent into 1000 by B number. So what is normality? 0.2. Number of gram equivalents we have to calculate, that one. Number of gram equivalents. In 2000. By how many ml of the solution?
ml.
So it becomes 0.2 into 250 by 1000. So it become 50 by 1000 in 0.05. So this is our answer. Now come to the question number. Page number 23, question number 27. Page number 23 and the question number 27. Page number 23. Question number 27. So what they are saying? Henry's law constant for the solubility of N2 gas in water at the given temperature. So the given KH 10 power 5 atmospheres. The mole fraction of N2 in air is 0.6. Mole fraction of N2 in air is 0.6. Number of moles of N2 from air dissolving 10 moles of water at a pressure 5 atmospheres. Pressure is 5 MPa. Number of moles of water is given as 10 moles. Number of moles of N2. Question. So this is the question. From here you calculate the partial pressure of N2. Partial pressure of N2 is equal to KH into mole fraction of N2. What is KH? 10 power 5. Mole fraction of N2? 0.6. You need the number of moles of N2. What is the formula for the number of moles? What is the formula for mole fraction? Mole fraction of N2 is equal to number of moles of N2 by total number of moles. Total number of moles means here two components are present, one is N2, another one is H2O. Mole fraction of N2, 0.6. Number of moles of N2 by, so number of moles of N2 plus number of moles of H2O. Okay? So here we just skipped a small step, we will complete that after all goes there. So first you calculate the mole fraction of N2 in A. Partial pressure of N2 is equal to partial pressure of N2 is equal to KH into mole fraction of N2. First we calculate the mole fraction of nitrogen gas in A. This is the mole fraction of nitrogen in water. This is the mole fraction of nitrogen in water. So I am substituting. So mole fraction, partial pressure of N2 is equal to mole fraction of nitrogen into total pressure. We have a formula. Partial pressure is equal to, I already wrote this formula in Henry's law. Henry's law, in 20 minutes before I written that formula. Look at that formula. So here I have written that those formulas in boxes. I said that these formulas are have to be used during the problem solving. I said that to look at that formulas, then you become easy. So KH into mole fraction of N2. So how much this one? They given 0.6. Total pressure 5 atmospheres is equal to KH 10 power 5. And this one data. So partial pressure of N2 is equal to total pressure into mole fraction of N2. Okay, here from here we will get in the n2. Number of moles of sulfur, mole fraction of n2. Here, don't compute. This one is in A. This one is in water. In A, they given 0.6. So, in water, mole fraction is equal to 3 into 10 power minus 1. Now, substitute all this values here. XN2 in 10 moles of water. How much this one? 3 into 10 power minus 5 is equal to number of moles of N2 by number of moles of N2 plus 10. So this one becomes 3 into 10 power minus 5. N2 plus 3 into 10 power minus 4 is equal to N2. So 3 into 10 power minus 4 is equal to 1 minus 3 into 10 power minus 5 into N2. This is very smallest 12. So approximately we take 1. So n2 is equal to 3 into 10 power minus. So this is our answer, first option. Next, look at the question number 28. Question number 28. So in question number 28, it just correct that one. That 0.195 is not the molarity, it is molality. M, small m. Molality. So molality is 0.195. Then Henry's law constant. They are asking pH. Question mark. And which thing they are given? At STP is given. At STP, the pressure is 0.987 bars. At STP, the pressure is 0.987 bars. Are you taking it? Well, I'm asking. So look at H2S is a toxic gas with rotten smell. Is used for qualitative analysis if the solubility of H2S in water at STP is 0.195 m. Henry's law constant is. So look at the mole fraction. They are asking Henry's law constant. Mole fraction is equal to molarity by molarity plus 55.5. So what is mole fraction? How you have to calculate the mole fraction? M is equal to 0.195 by 0.195 plus 55.5. So mole fraction is equal to. So 0.195 by 55.69. Now you have to calculate KH. So partial pressure of H2S is equal to KH into X. Mole fraction of H2S. What is the KH value? We have to calculate. I think of this pressure is given. Either you take this one or on atmosphere. I am taking this one. 987. And you take one atmosphere. take one atmosphere. KH into H2KH is 0.1955, 55.695. You will get the KH. This is the nearest value you are getting. You will not get the exact thing. 0.289, something like that you will get. So this is the KH. Next, look at 29 problem. What is that 29? KH is 1.67 into 10 power 8 pascals. After that, the quality of carbon dioxide in 500 ml of soda water when packed under 2.5 atmospheres. So partial pressure of carbon dioxide, pressure of carbon dioxide is 2.5 atmosphere. So if you want to convert that one into pascals, you have to convert that one into pascals because KH is given in pascals. So this will become this many pascals. From here you can calculate the mole fraction. So PCO2 is equal to KH into XCO2. So PCO2, 2.5 into 10 power 5 is equal to KH into XCO2. So XCO2 is equal to 2.5 into 10 power 5 by 1.69 into 10 power 29. So XCO2 equal to, so what they are asking, quantity of this one XCO2 0.00152. This is the mole fraction. Now we have to convert that one into number of moles. So to convert that one into number of moles, again that water is given in 500 ml of water. Number of moles of water is equal to 500 grams by 18. This 500 grams by 18 will come as 28 yearly. So X of CO2 is equal to number of moles of CO2 by number of moles of CO2 plus this 28. Number of moles of CO2 is very less, hence I am taking this one now only. So it is 0.00152 into 28 is equal to number of moles of CO2. These are the number of moles. When number of moles are converted, number of moles are multiplied with the gram of liquid, then you get the answer in grams. So weight of N2 is equal to number of moles of CO2 into gram molecular weight of CO2. So 0.00152 into 28 into 44. So done that one, we will get 1.848. You have to change the options. They are not given the options, that some mistakes happen in that one. So this is here. You are seeing this part only. Before that one, you are seeing only 0.5. This is not 0.5. This is 1.848. This is your answer. So these many grams of CO2. These many grams of CO2 is dissolved in 500 grams of. So these are the problems regarding in this law constant. After that, we have problems about Raoult's law, first law, for Raoult's law, second Raoult's law, second, and collative properties. We will complete all those things in next class. For this class, it is enough. We will meet next day. Thank you.